football in the Gulf is certainly not short of cash, but whilst enthusiasm for the game has been high, it has to be said that the region's small populations have meant that few local heroes have caught the eye. However, judicious spending has brought in several notable talents from abroad, and the current champions of the UAE, Al Jazeera, seem to have chosen their group of imports especially well.
People like Ricardo Oliveira and Matias Delgado are really good guys, even before you mention their football. They're very modest, very respectful, and they help the other players on the pitch and off. It really is a joy to play with players like Oliveira and Delgado. Players like that are superb, and I hope they stay with us at Al Jazeera for a long time to come.
The usual perception of a Gulf-bound player as either a low-ranking journeyman or a 40-year-old former star awaiting a final payday doesn't really apply to Ricardo Oliveira. The Brazilian started out with Portuguesa and soon broke into the national squad before earning a ticket to the European big leagues. But playing in the UAE these days is no easy option.
Everybody who comes from Europe to play here in the Arab world thinks that it's going to be easy, that it's easy to play here. But actually, it's very difficult. The weather is very hot, and the football is very fast, with a lot of running involved. I found it hard, but I kept on trying. But unfortunately, I got injured in pre-season, and though I played as much as I could only take it for about 6 months. When I was ready to come back, I felt that I really needed to show what I was capable of as a player. Everybody knew what I was like as a person, but I wanted to make some history here because I appreciated the investment that Al Jazeera made in me.
Ricardo Oliveira played 11 times in all for Brazil, being part of the Copa America winning squad in 2004. A free-scoring forward, his career in Europe included spells with Valencia, where he won a La Liga title, and Milan, with whom he celebrated a triumph in the Champions League. So what can he give to his new teammates?
I have a great deal of experience to transmit to my colleagues. I can show them that football really only depends on results. It doesn't matter what Ricardo Oliveira had done in Europe or with the Brazilian national team before he arrived here. What matters now is what he's going to do here. When I began playing here, perhaps I wasn't demonstrating the sort of football that had been expected when I was given the contract. But with hard work and sacrifice, the way I've always achieved things in life, as nothing was ever given to me, I was able to show them how important it is for us always to give our best on the pitch. It's important for us to help each other. That's what makes a team champions.
Al Jazeera won this year's UAE league title by some distance, but their stars have largely been foreigners. As well as Oliveira, there's another Brazilian Barre, former scourge of the J-League, and Diaki and Kabe from Ivory Coast. But from his point of view, does Oliveira see any locals who might have the quality to go the other way?
I've seen some good players here. They stay here, but if they had the opportunity to leave and go to Europe with a more competitive championship with greater ambitions to win things, then without a shadow of doubt, these players could easily do well in Europe. Just as when European and Brazilian players come here, players from here would be valued in the European market. But I really think that the club project here is excellent. A certain mentality has been instilled here by the coach. And he's done that along with Sheikh Mansour and Sheikh Hamdan and all the directors. They've all been giving their support to us and putting their trust in our hard work. We've been bringing in hard-working people with characters of the club. We've instilled some respect on the pitch. We're still ambitious to achieve things here, and we want to pass that on to all our colleagues.